Hi friends, welcome to Scodemy IS. Today, your host Rohit Biyani is here with a very important lecture on how to not commit the most common mistakes an aspirant does during his or her mains preparation. Right, so today we are going to talk about APSC. We are going to talk about APSC mains as it is approaching in the month of January, right? So let's see what are the 9 common mistakes or the most common mistakes a student does during his or her tenure that I also committed, right? Let me give a little brief about myself. I cleared my UPSC mains in 2020 and gave my interview this year in the year October. And now I'm here with you to share whatever I have learned in the entire journey. I hope you guys enjoy it. First and foremost, the most common mistake an aspirant does is hunting for materials. Every aspirant is there in the town and they are asking for more and more materials so that they can study and prepare holistically for their preparation, for their mains preparation. But do you know how many of that materials do you actually read? Most of the times, these materials stack up one over the other and finally they are given to the raddiwala. Yes or no? I have done the same. And I'm telling you, out of my experience, the lesser the content you have, the better it is. So less is more is the mantra here, right? When I talk about hunting for content always, let me speak in detail about how many ways there are to find materials. Obviously, there are coaching materials available. Everybody is following it. Then there are base books, which everybody is following it. Then we have websites which push materials online, and a lot of them are providing quality content, but the issue is people tend to follow too many websites at a single time, right? I would not name any of the websites, but my concern is when you get an exposure of too much of content, you get overwhelmed and you are handcuffed, right? What to read and what not to read. And that's the common question that I get is, sir, what to read and what not to read, right? So in today's lecture, I will talk in detail how you can stop hunting for materials. Rather, you pick up one or two sources and you revise those sources again and again, consolidate that content so that in the examination, you can actually recall that content. All right. Now, whenever you are preparing your notes, there is a common way. There is a very, very interesting way to prepare your notes. Let me give you a brief how to do that. First and foremost, you have to understand the pattern of the examination. Now, let me talk about the pattern of the examination. As you know that APSC has recently shifted to UPSC pattern. Yes or no? They have come out with a syllabus that is similar to UPSC. Moreover, apart from the syllabus change, it is a common belief that the number of questions and the pattern of questions will also be similar to UPSC, so that the state services students can apply for central services as well, right? So that if the pattern changes to UPSC, then the previous pattern, which used to contain 1 markers, 2 markers, 5 markers, 10 markers, may change to 2 types of questions, that is a 10 marker or a 15 marker. Now, what is a 10 marker and what is a 15 marker? A lot of students are having doubts how to attempt these 10 markers and 15 markers. How much space will be provided by the APSC so that we write an answer? Now, let me tell you about UPSC, and you can catch some glimpse of APSC from UPSC pattern. Now, there are, out of a 250 marks paper, there are approximately 20 questions. There are 20 questions, right? 10 questions belonging to 10 marker and 10 questions belonging to 15 marker. Now, in a 10 marker, you are given a limited space. You are given 2 pages to write. There is your question, and then you have your content that you're going to write in the first page and in the second page. Now, this is how a 10 marker pattern is. And in a 15 marker, instead of two pages, you will be getting 3 pages in order to write a content, right? And there will be a question and you have to write 3 pages. Now, trust me, when I say 2 pages and 3 pages, it has happened so that previously APSC students used to write in lengths. They used to take extra pages and write in lengths. But my experience with UPSC tells me that you have to write to the point, crisp points, and finish your answer within the stipulated time. Now, when I say time is a very, very important factor. Now, let me explain you again with calculation. When I say time, I'll give you a calculation, right? Since there are 10 questions of 10 markers and 10 questions of 15 markers. Yes or no? Now, let me give you a calculation. For example, if I take 6 minutes to write a 10 marker, then total I take approximately 6 into 10, 60 minutes. Yes or no? Okay. Now, if I move to a 15 marker, what will happen is, instead of 6 minutes, suppose I give myself 11 minutes to write an answer. There are 10 questions. It will come out to be 110 minutes. Now, please add up these 60 minutes and 110 minutes. They come out to be 170 minutes. Right, 170 minutes. Now, when you have 170, you have already utilized 170 minutes. That amount of time that you will be getting for a 250 marker paper will be 180 minutes, as it is 3 hours. 180 minutes is equal to 3 hours. Yes or no? And you know that these 10 minutes buffer, out of these 10 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes goes into the signing, the formalities part, the signing part, which will happen during the examination. So you are only left with 5 to 6 minutes or 7 to 8 minutes as your buffer. And the, trust me, this 7 to 8 minutes won't be there. Most of the times, we are struggling to find time. Most of the times, we lose on writing on questions because we did not manage our time properly. So time management is a key. And this is all connected. Once you start writing in time, then and only then you will be able to complete your paper. Once you complete your paper, then and only then you can think of clearing the mains. Yes or no? So my suggestion is, you guys try to write a 10 marker in a 6 minutes and a 15 marker in 11 minutes and see how much of the content that you are collecting can you put it on paper. How much of the content that you are collecting from different sources can you put it on paper? You will realize that out of the content, you are not even able to write 1/10 of the content. So my point is, when you are not able to write 1/10 of the content, why to read more? Read less. Reduce your stress. Rather, read very specific, read to the point, and make specific exam notes. Understood? Make specific exam notes. That is why I am saying the first mistake every aspirant does is collecting materials. And trust me, it is a rat race. Whenever your friend says that I have read content from a specific website, you may get anxious. You may want to read that content. Whenever a friend recommends any content, you may want to read that content so that you are there in the race. But trust me, this is all a trap. This is all a trap. Rather, you have to focus on lesser content and consolidating that content again and again so that you can maximize your score. I'm repeating it again. Please, 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 it's my humble request. Read less, read it multiple times so that you can take it to the examination and score good marks. All right?